Hey kids, where do you want to go?
Cuda's kitchen.
That's right. And boy, oh boy, are we gonna have big fun today. We're gonna have so much fun. We'll forget about how miserable we are and how much life sucks. And how we're all gonna grow old and die someday.
I wanna go home.
Shut up, you little weasel. Hope you enjoy it!
It's 8 in the morning.
Them that
let's make some breakfast.
Shall get, them that's not shall lose. So the Bible said, and it still is news. Mama may have, Papa may have, but God bless the child that's got his own.
Welcome to Cuda's Kitchen. We make a pizza for breakfast.
Empty pockets don't ever make a grave. Mama may have, Papa may have, but God bless the child that's got his own. That's got his own.
Bacon strips, bacon strips, bacon strips.
What you know about real food, hater?
Get the f*** out of here.
Check it out. We got a hot frying pan here. Gonna take some butter. Ready in the pan. Mushrooms, chopped up chili, chopped up rosemary. Just give the rosemary a rough chop. You don't gotta chop it up too much. Let those get going. Crushed pepper. A little bit of salt. You want to sauté those just till they let all the water out of them. They get nice and soft and they get a little bit of brown color on the outside. I made this pizza dough last night. Pizza dough is very easy to make. Just go on the internet, check out a recipe. It's dead simple. I made this a day before, so it's in the fridge ready to go. But there's nothing wrong with using store-bought pizza dough. That's, you know, saves you time, it's pre-made, and whatever. It's just as good. Check it out. I don't got a rolling pin, and maybe you don't have a rolling pin at home. Nothing wrong with using a wine bottle. I washed it off, sterilized it, it's clean. We're just gonna roll the pizza dough out. And to be honest, don't be afraid of what shape it turns out in. I'm gonna cook the pizza in a square pan, so I'm gonna try and go for a square as much as I can. But it doesn't have to be uniform. Don't be afraid of having a strange shape. You know, it's more organic, it's more homemade. Just roll that out. Clean your countertop off. Add some flour. Try and keep it even thickness. You can flip it over a few times. Roll it around in the flour. If you want to be a supreme master chef pizza maker, this skill takes a bit of time to learn, but basically, to stretch the dough out and make it more wide, you want to get your fists in there. Get your two fists and just start rolling, right? Then you get that. Stretch it out. Go like this with your fist back and forth. One more little toss, throw it back down.
I don't understand what's wrong with the world, you know? I know people personally that can't even cook for themselves. They go out, spend money, spend their hard-earned guap all day buying takeout food. You can't even cook a meal for yourself? Fuck. I mean, you take half the money you spend on a takeout meal every day, buy some ingredients and make yourself some food, you're flying on God's airplane.
Dude, don't eat that shit.
What?
That's poisonous. Stupid.
I got a broken toe. Let's make some pizza.
Whenever you get mad at a woman, don't kick a piece of cement. Bam, we back in Cuda's kitchen, about to build a breakfast pizza right now. The beautiful thing about pizza is you can design it and build it accordingly to your own tastes. I just went in the refrigerator, I saw what I had left over for some meats, some vegetables, and I just used it. It's like a clean out the fridge pizza kind of thing. So let's go ahead and build the pizza. I got my pizza dough on the tray here, and I mean, you don't have to be traditional, use tomato sauce. This is a favorite thing of mine when I'm making pizza, I take some cream. You in North America use 35% cream, if you're overseas, use full cream. So I'm just going to go in, a little bit of cream around, and that's going to be your sauce. Now, I have minced garlic. I'm going to take that, put it right there on that cream, and just work the garlic in with the cream. I got three kinds of cheese here today. Like I said before, use whatever cheese, whatever your flavor is. Today, I got some shredded mozzarella cheese. I have some Asiago, and this is a special cheese from France. It's sort of like halfway in between goat's cheese and a brie. So I'm gonna hit that with the mozzarella first. And when I'm making pizza, you know, don't oversaturate it. You don't need too much cheese, because you don't want to kill the other flavors on the pizza. So I get that shredded mozzarella, right? Just a few pieces of Asiago. Break it up. Like I said before, nothing has to be uniform, you know? Doesn't matter if things are different size, different shape. Spread it around. Asiago cheese. Next up, spinach. This spinach is pre-cooked. Important when you're using spinach, especially for something like this, drain the water. If all that water goes on your pizza, you're gonna end up with a lake. Just squeeze it. Cook your spinach, take the water out. Spread that around. Take those nice mushrooms we sauteed in butter, rosemary, some fresh chili, salt, pepper. Spread those around. I had a little bit of leftover salami left over in the fridge, so why not use it up? I just sliced it thinly. I'm gonna spread that around. Chopped bacon. I love bacon. Put lots on. Last but not least, I'm just going to put a little bit of cheese on top of that to finish it. Like I said, I got that nice cheese here. It's like halfway between goat's cheese and brie. Just a few slices, you know. Don't go crazy. Just put a couple nice pieces of that around, you know. Right? Got a few more pieces of that Asiago cheese. Spread that around. Little bit fresh pepper on top.
Put some icing on your cake.
Straight in the oven. One thing I love about cooking is condiments. Who says you can't have a condiment on top of your pizza? You put ketchup on French fries, don't you? Check this. Cherry tomatoes. Just gonna cut those in half. Quickly. Nothing fancy. Just half those. Into the bowl. I have some fresh parsley here. Just bunch that up. Don't even gotta chop it too much. Rough chop. A little bit of parsley. Fresh pepper.
Put some icing on your cake.
A little bit of salt. Olive oil. Balsamic vinegar. A few drops. In like that. Toss it up.
Woo!
Who wants some breakfast? Look at that. Now, while it's still hot, while it's fresh out the oven, take that little tomato salad you made there. That's my cuda ketchup. Just place those gingerly around that pizza. Look at that. Take those tomatoes. Just put them around. Spread the love, know what I mean? All those juices left in the bowl, go right in. Drizzle that. Wash your hands, fam. Cuda's Kitchen. Next episode, Monday morning. HD, I promise. Bon appetit.